Hello everybody and welcome back to another Deep Ogre Review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the brand new Transformers Kingdom Dinobot. Now I got mine off of eBay, as did many of the other people I have seen get him. But he is showing up in stores and I think he's on CMD. So if you guys want your Dinobots, go get them. If you're lucky enough, you might have a store that has them. If you're not, then go on CMD or eBay. Anyway, I really love this guy. I couldn't stop taking photos of him for about 3 days. But he's really, really good. And let's just get into his accessories, because I want to get to the figure as soon as possible. So here we have his famous twirling sword, although it does not twirl. It is done in that pink that we kind of saw on the Masterpiece version, but it's not like chromed out like that one was. It's more of a dull pink, but it's still kind of metallic. You have the hilt right here. You can see where it goes in. It's kind of like a rubbery material, but I wouldn't bend it too far because it will snap. It's like those bendable pencils. But that, yeah, it's just basically the sword. It's very show accurate. And here, earlier, of course, we saw his little shield, spinny shield thingy. Obviously, it's just the dinosaur tail. And you can obviously just put it in there to have that. He sometimes used it like this in a show. I don't remember seeing it that often, though. But I know that the original toy could do this. But one thing you can't do that the original toy could, and the Masterpiece version, I think, is stick the sword in horizontally. You just can't. I don't know why. I don't know why they have this clip, because to me at least, it doesn't look like it needs to have that. They could have just made this a full thing and not have had that. But I don't know, maybe it was more cost-effective to do, who knows. But he can hold it clearly like that, just with that side peg, plug it into his hand, and he can hold it. Looks very, very good with it in his hand. And there's that port right there, or that peg right there, and just put it in there. And there you have Dinobot with his accessories. And while we have the camera up close, let us just get into his details. Smooth transition. So basically, for his head sculpt, I just absolutely love this head sculpt. It is the most Dinobot thing I have ever seen. It's on par with the Masterpiece. You have some Marvelization going on with the helmet, which, I don't know, I kind of like it. Like right here, you can see it. Over here, then you have his tubing and lines going across here with those rigid lines. And I'm really surprised how well they got that black down here. Because without it, I don't think this head sculpt would look as good as it does. You have black for the eyebrow that goes all the way around. Then you have his weird pointy down nose, his Dr. Doofenshmirtz jaw. The only thing that I would have liked to see is like maybe either an opening mouth, which is $30, you're not gonna, that's probably not gonna happen, but or an alternate head, because it's really easy just to pop this one off. And it would have been really cool, because we don't regularly get Transformers with alternate heads, you know, god damn it. But it is hard to put back on there. But he has a beautiful Smurf blue for his face. His eyes are pointy, you know what I mean. Like, he's scowled, as Dinobot always is. You have his shoulder pads coming down. One complaint is like that, but that's it. That's the only complaint, really. And that, but that doesn't really, you know, matter in the long run, honestly. Doesn't look too bad. You have that faux chest piece right here with the eyes. It's kind of obvious that this is the actual Velociraptor head, but, you know, what are you gonna do? Blue and kind of the golden rib cage around here. his bony crotch. I guess you could say he has a boner. Get it? WandaVision. WandaVision. But then down here, you have more of that yellowish, kind of goldish plastic for his hips. Then his legs have that metallic version of this, kind of reptile, kind of more texture right here. He has that all throughout. Really nice, really nice. Then down here, just brown, or I wouldn't call it brown. It's more like honey, I guess. Honey down here. Gray for the knee coming across to the shoulder pad. And his foot with a heel spur. So overall, this guy looks really good. Of course, he looks more realistic, like all of the other Kingdom Beast Wars figures so far, than the show, but still looks show accurate, which is pretty impressive on Hasbro's part, I do gotta admit. So it's really nice. I really love all the details this guy has, but let's get into size comparisons. Here he is next to figures that I would think most people would have by this point. It's the ER Seeker mold, specifically Skywarp, and the Earthrise Optimus Prime. And here he is next to some Star Wars figures. We have the Greef Karga and the Beskar Mando. So here he is next to the Predacons that we have in Kingdom so far. We have Black Rechnia and, of course, Megs. And he looks really good with Megs. He just fits in so well with all the Beast Wars characters. It's insane. I think the size on these two, they nailed it. But if this was the size with Optimus Primal, instead of, you know, the smaller Optimus Primal that we got, if he was Dinobot size, I would be perfectly happy. If Dinobot was a little bit bigger, I would be perfectly happy. But as far as Dinobot and Megatron goes, this is damn near perfect. And lastly, but not leastly, here we have him next to Rat Trap and Optimus Primal. I don't know why I said that in a Megatron voice, but here we have him next to his arch nemesis of the Maximals. They never seem to get along. Here he is next to Rat Trap. Already reviewed him, and Black Arachnia, and Megatron, and Optimus Primal. And yeah, they look really good together, honestly. I really love this, especially Rat Trap next to Dinobot. I just love the way they all look together. They fit in so nicely. And here he is next to Cheetor, I guess. So for articulation, real quick, he has a lot more articulation than you might think. Obviously, we have a ball joint up the head, look up, look down, and of course, all tied to tilt and swirl and everything. Arm can go full 360, can go up about that far, and because there's a hinge right here, up all the way like that. Bicep swivel kind of tight on mine, but it'll work loose. Single jointed elbow that goes back to wrist swivel. Fingers are on a hinge so they can go in and out. Waist swivel. Legs can kick up about the... Sorry, my recording stopped. But legs can kick up about that far. And back about that far, out about that far. There is a really tight thigh swivel, at least on mine. It's pretty tight, especially on this leg. Oof. Single jointed knee can bend up about that far, forward, just like the elbows. And no ankle swivel, ankle rotation. There we go. But you do get down, up, and a really, really good ankle pivot. So, honestly, that's all you could really ask for. Plus, the articulation allows you to pull off some really, really, really nice poses. Like, his balance is on point, too. I don't know if you guys follow me on Instagram. You should, by the way, @skywarp_rules_1984. But, on my story, I did put Dinobot doing a handstand, one hand stand a couple of times. If I could get it on camera, that would be awesome. There we go. So you can, he really does have a really nice center of balance. So you can get a lot of really good poses. You can get a lot of really good action poses out of him too. Like, if I could find my golden disc, that would be awesome. But he can hold the golden disc, albeit he has to hold it with both hands. But he can hold it nonetheless. Plus, he looks super, super, super good with his accessories in, looking like he's about to kick either some Predacon ass. Oh, ooh. Kick either some Predacon ass or some Maximal ass, depending on what time frame you're going by. So he just looks amazing in almost every pose you put him in. Honestly, he has a really good center of balance, so you can get him in like a really nice running pose. That ankle pivot really helps. It's so good. It's just so phenomenally sculpted. And articulation is amazing. So I just really can't really find anything to complain about this guy, at least in robot mode. But we'll get to my complainy area into the transformation and, well, to Dino or the Velociraptor mode in general. So let's do that. If you couldn't tell, I was starting to get really, really pissed at this figure. That's why I just cut away and transformed the rest of it off screen, because I just couldn't. I couldn't do it in front of the fucking camera. I don't know why. I just hate this transformation. And it's not even that good of a dino mode. I mean, look at it. He looks like the perk hit different with this one, bro. The perk hit different. I'm telling ya. And it's not a big deal. But what the fuck is this? Yet again, I thought it would be way more annoying. But what the fuck is this? That's really annoying. I don't know why. It's less annoying than I thought it would be. Then you have eyes on his thighs right here. He has some junk in the trunk, too. I mean, look at that. He's thick. Holy fuck. It doesn't even have good articulation. You can't even, like, no head swivel, but jaw, and he can't even look up that far. There's a hinge that can come out about that far. Swivel all the way around. Single jointed elbow. Back, just like the dino, or the bot mode. And a ball joint at his limp dick wrist hands. I mean, what the fuck? What the fuck is this? Tell me, what the fuck is this? Hasbro, why do you make us do this? Look at him. He looks like a fucking chicken. Ah, I hate it. I hate it, but it's still my favorite figure. But I hate it. It's just not even that good of a dino mode. It's honestly really, really not. So, I don't know. But you do have hinge out here, I guess. And that swivel still retains, and you have that knee, and everything that the arm had, but you can't even, like, kick the legs back. You can't. You just can't. So it's not even, like, a good running pose, even. I don't know. I just really, really don't like it. It's just... Honestly, though... Everything else makes up for it. Just everything in the robot mode makes up for this hot garbage. Hot garbage, I'm telling you. But, yeah, let's get into my final thoughts. Can't wait to transform this guy back. Yay. So, for my final thoughts, clearly, I absolutely adore this guy. It is honestly my favorite figure in my collection now. I just cannot put him down. I can't stop messing with him. He looks so good. Dinobot is actually one of my favorite Beast Wars characters, besides Tigatron. And my third favorite Transformers character in general. I just absolutely love this guy. His transformation and his Velociraptor mode suck, but everything else, the paint, the sculpt, the head sculpt especially, just the articulation and the expression you can get out of this figure, it just makes up for it. It just makes up for it for me, honestly. It overplays to Megatron, which I love that figure. It also has a pretty shit transformation and a shit dino mode, but it just, Dinobot, he's amazing. I love him so much, and this just makes me so happy that we're getting a Tigatron, because Tigatron is actually my second favorite Transformers character ever. So, I don't know. He looks so good with the Maximals and the Predacons. I cannot wait to start my Beast Wars series. So if you guys liked this video, like it, subscribe if you're new, and comment. Also, obviously already stated, I have an Instagram. I have a Femboy account at Femwarp_XWX. And thank you guys for watching. Peace.
A lot of people ask me stupid fucking questions. A lot of people think that what I say on record or what I talk about on a record that I actually do in real life or that I believe in it. Or if I say that I want to kill somebody that I'm actually going to do it or that I believe in it. Well, shit, if you believe that, then I'll kill you. You know why? Because I'm a criminal! Jagged edge, I'll stab you in the head, whether you're a fag or less. Is it a homo sex, a math, or a trans or vest? Pants or dress, hate facts, the answer's yes. Homophobic, nah, you just heterophobic. Staring in my jeans, watching my genitals bulging. That's my motherfucking balls, you better let go of them. They belong in my scrotum, you'll never get hold of them. Hey, it's me, Versace, whoops, somebody shot me. And I was just checking the mail, get it, checking the mail. How many records you expecting to sell after your second LP sends you directly to jail? Come on, relax, guy, I like amen, right, Ken? Needs Jesus, heal his child, help us destroy these demons. Oh, please send me a brand new car and a prostitute while my wife's sick in the hospital. Preacher, preacher, fifth grade teacher, you can't reach me, my mom can't neither. You can't teach me a goddamn thing, cause I watch TV and Comcast cable. And you ain't able to stop these thoughts. You can't stop me from topping these charts. And you can't stop me from dropping each march with a brand new CD for these fucking retards. And the thing is just little old me. Mr. Don't give a fuck, still won't leave. I'm a criminal. Cause every time I write a rhyme, these people think it's a crime to tell them what's on my mind. I guess I'm a criminal. I don't gotta say a word, I just flip in the bird and keep going. I don't take shit from no one. I'm a criminal. Cause every time I write a rhyme, these people think it's a crime to tell them what's on my mind. I guess I'm a criminal.